Today, we're talking about organisms that show little or no signs of biological aging. These are the immortals, and this is negligible senescence.
Growing up isn't always fun.
Well, I'm doing a little bit each day. I can't do very much, but I can do just a little at a time.
Growing up is fun, but some of the things Molly used to do seem a little silly now. Growing up, it's an exciting time.
Hi, I'm Aranya Iyer, your ageless host, and this is Animalogic Second Nature. We are a species obsessed with aging. We're constantly trying to battle the gray hair, wrinkles, and especially disease and mental and physical deterioration that comes with getting older. While it may be straightforward for us humans, on a scientific level, aging is extremely difficult to define and is far from universal. Dozens of theories for aging have been floated to explain it in evolutionary terms.
Certainly, the human race hasn't been here long enough to see a star go through its birth processes, its coming of age, its maturity, and its death.
Negligible senescence is a real mouthful, so let's break it down. Senescence is the trend, on a cellular level, where individuals of a population increasingly experience disease and deterioration as they age, leading eventually to death. Negligible here means that the rate of disease and death in relation to age isn't statistically significant. What that means is that the risk of disease and death is stable, or, in some organisms, even decreasing over time. Sometimes, establishing senescence is difficult because it's hard to study long-living organisms in the wild. For example, we know that Galapagos tortoises are the longest-living reptile. Their lifespans exceed a century in the wild and almost twice as long in captivity. But the jury is still out on if they actually age or not. So let's take a look at some of the enduring organisms whose status of negligible senescence is still under investigation. For that, we need to dive deep into the ocean to see the longest living vertebrate in the world, the record-breaking Greenland shark. Greenland sharks can live for hundreds and hundreds of years in the Arctic and subarctic. They're actually the only species to inhabit these icy waters year-round. One theory as to how these sharks can live so long is that they've adapted to the cold by slowing down their metabolism, which slows down all other processes as well. Greenland sharks do everything slow. They grow a minuscule 1 centimeter a year. They swim just 3 kilometers an hour. They only reach sexual maturity after about a century. Their unhurried pace of life means that aging is slow too. Not much is known about the Greenland shark, as they're extremely tricky to observe in the wild. The first photograph of a Greenland shark wasn't even taken until 1995. Now that we're firmly deep under the sea, we've reached the depths of agelessness. Hydra vulgaris. These tiny palm tree-looking cnidaria measure just 1 to 3 centimeters in length and are 1 millimeter wide. They're also virtually immortal in lab environments. Every 20 days, this tiny everlasting invertebrate completely regenerates itself, thanks to its stem cells that are in a continuous state of renewal. From what we've seen, and we've been studying its eternal qualities since the mid-1700s, it doesn't age, and it doesn't die. If you cut pieces of a hydra off, it will simply regenerate. That's why it was named after the serpent in Greek mythology, where 2 heads grow back with every one that's chopped off. Even more impressive, if you scramble the cells of a hydra and squish them into a ball, the cells will rearrange and a new hydra will grow. The only things that kill a hydra in the wild are extreme weather events, disease, being gobbled up by predators, and Captain America. Recent studies have shown that they do slow down their asexual reproduction over time, which is a sign of aging, but research is ongoing. There is just one creature that one-ups the hydra in its avoidance of the slow march towards death, and that is the appropriately named immortal jellyfish. This is the only species that we know of that can be called truly biologically immortal. This small jellyfish, which lives in waters all around the world, can actually reverse its aging process and revert to an earlier stage of its life cycle if it experiences stress or injury. Imagine being able to Benjamin Button yourself back to an embryo at the smallest inconvenience. This all just goes to show that the concept of senescence is as slippery as an immortal jellyfish. So let's take a look at some of the enduring organisms whose status of negligible senescence is still under investigation, like the ocean quahog, which can live to be at least 400 years old. One theory about how bivalve mollusks live so long is that they have high antioxidant capacity, which slows the aging process. Just take a look at any of the labels found on anti-aging products on the market today to see how us humans have tried to bottle that power.
While it may not be necessary for all of you, some girls use a lubricating cream or lotion to prevent skin roughness or chapping. Expensive creams and powders, however, aren't necessary. A healthy skin can be kept attractive with only a few simple preparations.
Rough-eye rockfish have also been recorded to live 140 years. We know this by measuring the rings of the small bones in their ears, called otoliths. Just like a tree's rings, the otolith gives researchers an exact read on just how old a fish is. Despite these potentially advanced ages, scientists are still trying to determine if rough-eye rockfish actually experience negligible senescence. Despite being the longest-living arthropod, and what the memes say, American lobsters are not immortal, and they do experience senescence. They do, however, have the immortality enzyme, which is responsible for their long lives.
But now the lobster tries to get even. He demands cool, damp moss in which to live, and he refuses to live long if he doesn't get it.
This enzyme, called telomerase, is present in many lobster cells and allows the cells to keep dividing so that the lobster can keep growing and regenerating.
While the lobster is known as one of the world's greatest food delicacies, he is also famous for being just about the world's dumbest creature.
Human stem cells contain telomerase too. Lobsters grow throughout their lives, molding their shell and building a new one with each growth spurt. The theory is that this cycle costs the lobster a lot of energy. So, as they age, this growth and molting slows down until the cost becomes too high and the lobster dies of literal exhaustion. This happens to an estimated 10 to 15% of lobsters. The other 85 to 90% end up melted in butter.
He may be dumb, but as the main course for a delicious dinner, he's the tops.
Freshwater pearl mussels exhibit many characteristics that are typical for negligible senescence. They grow throughout their long lives, which can be over a century. They don't lose their ability to reproduce, and there are no noticeable differences between young and old individuals. The probability of pearl mussels dying does, however, increase with age. One study suggests that pearl mussels are an example of why negligible senescence isn't actually a thing. Our journey through immortality continues high up in the Rocky Mountains with the Great Basin Bristlecone Pine, the longest living non-colonial plant in the world. The oldest individuals that we know of are over 5,000 years old and show no signs of slowing down. Another everlasting tree is the quaking aspen, which, unlike the bristlecone pine, is a clonal colony tree. This means that all individuals in an aspen stand are genetically identical and just part of one huge underground root system. These aspen groves can live to be thousands and thousands of years old. Aspen are coated to survive. A thin layer of their bark photosynthesizes, so they can continue to grow even in winter, when all other deciduous trees have gone dormant for the season. Aspen can stand drought, fire, and basically anything you can throw at it, and only need one thing to survive: lots and lots of sunlight.
We know that green plant pigment, chlorophyll, is produced in plants only when they are exposed to sunlight. Keep a plant in the dark, and the leaves lose that rich green color. They become pale, and the plant slowly dies.
As the roots spread, they search for the best sunny spots. and once found, will spring up new trunks. Even if an individual tree is killed by a browsing animal, the other trees and the underground root system are unaffected. Losing a tree is like clipping a toenail. And if proper sunlight is blocked by other trees, the roots can lay in wait for a century or more until conditions improve. While individual trees only live about 150 years, one colony of aspen in Utah's Fish Lake National Forest is estimated to be 80,000 years old. Ginkgo biloba trees are also able to live for thousands of years, and when studied on a cellular level, show no signs of senescence. A study that compared a range of ginkgo trees, aging from 20 to 600, found no difference in their efficiency of seed germination, photosynthesis, nor disease resistance. The gene activity was the same, and the researchers couldn't find any evidence of programmed death. When ginkgos do die, it's usually from external factors like disease, storms, fire, and logging.
Smokey, I saw him right out there in the woods.
Smokey's everywhere, Chris, reminding us to guard against fire, to exercise vision and keep these wonderful forests as they are, safe for all of us, now and in the future. Be sure that campfire's out, Candy, dead out.
That's right. Plenty of water, stirred good.
And be sure to break your match in two. And when you're through smoking, crush that cigarette.
That's what Smokey says.
And that goes for all of us, folks. Let's do as Smokey says and protect our forests.
So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to hit subscribe for new episodes every week. Stay timeless, and I'll see you later. Bye. Negligible sunlight. Woo! Okay. Negligible senescence is the appropriately named immortal jellyfish.